Hello everyone, today we are going to deal with fourth unit, that is Right to Information Act. So what is the purpose or what is the object behind passing this legislation, this law, that is Right to Information Act? This act, this law was passed in the year 2005. Now what is the purpose? So the purpose of this act is to bring transparency and accountability in the working of the public authorities for the benefit of the public at large. So whenever the public authorities, public offices are functioning, they are functioning for the sake of the people of India. So we the citizens, for us these offices are functioning. So this act wants, or this act objects to bring transparency. So whenever these offices are working, the working of these offices should be transparent. It should be open to all the citizens to view the way these offices are working, and these public offices, they should be accountable to the public, to the citizens of the country. Then this act was passed in order to empower the citizens. So India is a democratic country, and we the citizens, we form the government. And this act was passed to empower the citizens, to give the information to the citizens regarding public offices, whatever information is required by them, to contain corruption, to stop corruption, and to make our democracy work for the people in real sense. So these are the objectives, or these are the purposes with which this act came into existence in the year 2005. Right, this right is available to whom? So this right is available to all the citizens of India. So each and every citizen of India, if he wants, if he requires any information concerning any public authority, public office, government offices, he can have an access to that information through the procedure which has been mentioned in this Right to Information Act. This information can be obtained within 30 days from the date of request. So the person, the citizen who wants any information regarding any public office, he has to make an application, give an application. After giving an application in writing or in electronic form, within 30 days of application, he should get the information. If the concerned authority does not provide the information, then there is a penalty which has to be paid by that government officer. Every public authority is under an obligation to provide information on written request or request in electronic means. Means the information seeker can give a written application, or an application for the information can be given in electronic form also. It is the duty, it is the obligation of every public authority to provide the information which has been asked by the citizen under the provisions of this act. But there is certain information which is prohibited. So it is not compulsory for the government officers to provide each and every kind of information, but there are certain exemptions for providing the information. Which are the exemptions? So, which information is exempt from disclosure? The disclosure of that information will affect the security, sovereignty, and integrity of India. If that information is disclosed, that information disclosure is against the security of our country. Sovereignty means independence of our country, and if it is against the unity of India, then in that case the concerned government authority may refuse to give an information, because the disclosure of that information is prohibited, it is exempt under the provisions of this act. Again, the information which is forbidden to be published by the court or tribunal, then in that case that disclosure of that information may result in contempt of court. Court has given an order that any kind, particular kind of information should not be disclosed. In that case, the disclosure of that information is exempt. The concerned authority may refuse to give that information because the disclosure may amount to contempt of court, that is insult of court. Then, any information which is received in confidence from foreign government, such information is also exempt from disclosure. Again, any information which is dangerous to the life or physical security or physical safety of any person, such information which is given in confidence, the disclosure of information is exempt. Now, what is the importance of this act? This law, that is Right to Information Act, this act empowers the people. It gives a power to people, that means citizens of the country, to ask for information about central or state government. So, which are the offices which have to give information? This act is applicable only to public offices, not to private offices. But this act is applicable. Information seeker can ask for the information from central or state government offices, which includes non-governmental organizations also. Which non-governmental organizations? Which are substantially funded by the government. The information of such organizations can also be asked under the provisions of RTI Act. So only the government offices, central government offices which come under central or state government, and the organizations which are substantially funded by the government, they come under the provisions of this RTI Act, not the private institutions, private organizations or private offices. Now, what is the benefit? What is the use of this act? This act ensures that the people we put in power remain answerable to us always. And by no means can they use public funds arbitrarily. So, this means that we, the people, or we, the citizens of the country, we have put these people, these government officers or these politicians in power. So, always these people should be answerable to the general public. And whatever money, so whenever any developmental activity or is carried on, any developmental activity, may take an example, dams, construction of dams or constructions of roads, etc. These are the developmental activities carried on by the government. So from where the money comes for these developmental activities? So, this is the money which is being paid by the taxpayers. So, we, the citizens of India, we are paying the tax. So, either direct tax or indirect tax. So, whenever we purchase something, we are paying the tax on it. So, we are the taxpayers, and our money is being used by the government for these projects, etc. And this money should not be used by the government, by the public authorities, arbitrarily, means however they want, they should not use that fund. So this act makes sure that the citizens, the people of India, the taxpayers of India, we should always keep these government officials, they should be always answerable to us, and they should not use public funds, public money arbitrarily, however they want. So it is one of the most powerful legislation. So this act is very powerful legislation. From democratic viewpoint, it is very important for the citizens to give such powers to the citizens. And this is a law in the hands of the people, which gives them power to ask for the information from the government. So we can ask any information regarding government offices through this provisions of this Right to Information Act. Why this act was passed? During British regime, during British period, British colony, we were being ruled by the Britishers. At that time, Britishers had passed one act, that was Official Secrets Act. This law was passed in the year 1923. And as per the provisions of this act, certain offices, working of the offices was kept secret. Citizens or the people who are being ruled by the government, being ruled by the British rule, they were not supposed to ask for any kind of information. So after independence, India became a democratic country, even though such practice was going on. After that, to curb the effects of Official Secrets Act, Freedom of Information Act was passed in the year 2002. So this Freedom of Information Act has some lacunae, and in order to overcome those gaps in Freedom of Information Act, the new legislation, Right to Information Act, came into existence, or it was passed in the year 2005. So, Right to Information Act, it is an act which is considered as a part of fundamental rights. So, we have, our constitution has provided certain rights to the citizens of India in the form of fundamental rights, and it is considered that Right to Information Act is a part of fundamental rights mentioned in Article 19 of the Constitution. Article 19 says that every citizen has freedom of speech and expression. So Article 19 of the Constitution has given freedom of speech and expression, and therefore citizens have a right to know how their money is being spent. So it is one of the fundamental rights. We are the taxpayers, we are paying money, and through that money government is spending, government officers are being carried on, and we have every right to know how our money is being spent by the government. Which are the government offices which comes under the ambit of this act? Issue of passport. So passport issuing authority in the government that is responsible for, under the provisions of this act, for the citizens of India. Next is issue of any type of license. Any type of license which is issued by the government of India or government officers, that comes under Right to Information Act. Issue of various types of certificates. Which certificates? Like marriage certificate, death certificate, then SCST or OBC certificate. These authorities are responsible. So which authority is responsible for issuing passport? So in India, the Ministry of External Affairs is authority to issue the passports. If there is delay in issuing the passports, if you have given an application for change or applied for new passport, etc., and there is a delay, so it has to be issued within 45 days of an application, and still you have not been issued the passport, new passport. Now you want to ask what has been done with respect to your application. Then you can make an application through Right to Information Act, asking the concerned authority, where is your application, what has been done with that. So within 45 days you should have been received passport, and still I have not received passport. What is the status of that document which I have given? You have applied for new ration card. Within 10 days after application of ration card, you should get it, but still you have not received. You want to know the status of your application for issuing ration card. You can give an application under RTI. What is the status of your a card which has to be issued by you, etc. So issuing of certificates, various kinds of death certificate, marriage certificate, birth certificate, these are to be issued by the government officers. And if they are not issuing it, or if they are not performing it properly, you can ask under RTI. Collection of water, electricity or telephone bills. Claiming various kinds of refunds. So refunds from income tax. So you are getting refund on the tax which have been already deducted by the income tax department from your income. TDS has been done, and now you have to get the refund from the income tax officer, income tax department. You have not received it. So you can ask for the information that what is a status regarding which you were supposed to receive the tax refund. Thank you.